John is going to start us off this hour in Washington, D.C. Hey, John, how are you?
Good. How are you?
Better than I deserve. How can we help?
So I am 19 years old, and I've never really been good with money. However, I just inherited around $100,000, and I was wondering what I should do to not blow this opportunity.
Man, that's a good question, John. Do you have any debt right now?
I'm in school right now, and I will end with around $20,000 student debt.
You'll end with about $25,000 in debt?
I will end with around like $20,000, yeah.
Okay, cool. How much time do you have left in school?
I'm a junior right now. Currently, I have around $11,000 at this very moment.
Cool. So when it comes to this inheritance, John, here's what I want you to do right now. I want you to take some of this inheritance money and finish school 100% debt-free. So stop borrowing money. Go ahead and pay cash for the rest. Go ahead and put at least 3 months in the savings account. Then also what I want you to do is, because you said you haven't made wise decisions with money, I want you to sit down with an investor. I want you to start investing into your future once you get done with college 100% debt-free. Okay, so right now what I want you to do is take some of that money, put it into an emergency fund.
What are you studying in school?
Marketing.
Where did the inheritance come from? Who passed?
My grandfather.
Okay. All right. So here's the challenge. You just are learning to ride a bicycle, and you were handed a high-powered motorcycle.
It's a great analogy.
Which, and you were very wise and self-aware and said, this kind of scares me. I don't want to mess this up and wreck, right?
Correct.
Okay. So a couple things you can do. One is sit down, as Anthony said, with maybe one of the SmartVestor pros and get someone in your corner that you can talk to. Are your parents good with money?
I wouldn't say so. No.
No? Okay. All right. So what we've got to do is get someone that you can talk to that is dependable and can kind of be in your corner and coach you and walk with you until you get your skills up and therefore your confidence up. In the meantime, I would suggest you remain very afraid in the sense of don't screw this up because you will live with a life of regret. And so you need to set this money to the side, just pretend like you don't have it except to pay cash for school, and you can go ahead and pay off that loan. But if you were to pay off the loan that you have and you were to finish school and there was all the other money left over sitting there waiting on you and you didn't touch it because you went ahead and got a job and you worked for your other expenses and that kind of thing, and you didn't buy anything stupid with this money or spend anything stupid or give it to your crazy cousin or something like that, then you get out of school, I think your grandfather would be smiling, don't you?
Absolutely.
Yes, I do.
And so your new goal is a noble calling, and the noble calling is to be careful, conservative enough that when you finish this story, your grandfather is in heaven smiling that he left you this inheritance instead of shaking his head going, my, that grandson of mine is stupid. Right?
Okay.
You don't want that answer, right?
Right.
No, I do not.
And so that you're, and you didn't, that's why you called.
Right.
Okay. And we're going to help you. I'm going to give you the best training program on money in the on the planet. Yeah. It's Financial Peace University is a part of Ramsey Plus, and I'm going to pay for it. I don't need any of your money. Okay.
Okay.
And I want you to start taking these classes online immediately and start learning about money, because you now have an increased level of responsibility and power that you have to control. Because power out of control will crush your butt. Mm-hmm. And that's your fear that you're going to mess this up. But power in control lifts things mightily. And you are in a position to lift your life mightily with the power of this $100,000. You will be shocked at how fast it will leave you if you do not control it. It'll be gone so fast.
Yeah, that's what I'm afraid of.
Yeah. So hang on. I'm going to have Kelly pick up. We're going to put you in Ramsey Plus. I'm going to pay for it. I want you to start those classes immediately, meet with a SmartVestor Pro, and exactly what Anthony was saying, pay off the student loan, yeah, and then lay out a budget for the next 3 years for the school. What's it going to take to graduate? What's it going to? What's the tuition, the books? What have you got to do to finish the degree? And you know, what's your living expenses? And take that money and start paying it out of that $100,000 as you go, and don't do anything else. You're not buying a car. You're not going on a trip. You're graduating from college. After you graduate from college debt-free, if there's money left over, and there will be,
yeah,
then you can start talking about some purchases, because by then you will have trained yourself, and the next time I talk to you, you're going to say, my name is John from Washington, D.C., and I'm really good at handling money.
And I would even say, John, to consider this, nothing wrong with buying something small, making a small purchase, but somewhat act like the money's not even there.
Yeah.
You know,
exactly.
Just, you know what? Hey, that's for my future. I'm gonna invest it. I'm gonna buy a nice little $5,000 car, $10,000 car at the age of 19. That's a good car. So I would really act like, okay, I'm gonna do the things I have to do so that tomorrow I can do the things that I really want to do, and I can make my grandpa proud of me because of the future. So
that's
a really
good question. Yeah. But anytime you receive an inheritance, folks, one thing you want to do is you say, What use of this money would make the person who passed and left it to me proud?
Yeah.
How can I can honor their memory. I can honor their life by handling this gift of the inheritance well, in a way that causes them smiling at me from heaven.
Yeah.
And that calls you to a noble thought pattern rather than a debased, selfish, childish, I want to blow all this money on myself.
Yeah.
You know, I want to screw off and party the money away. And because you can look at it and go, you will not live with regret. And regret is a bitter taste in the back of your mouth. You will not live with the regret if you handle it in a way that the person that left it to you is proud.
Yeah.
And you know, by the way, if they left money to you, it's because they did good stuff with money. Broke people don't leave an inheritance.
That's right. They leave you bills.
Yeah. Trouble.